we have come to a point in healthcare that basically the system has become unfixable.
It's going to take 300 years to train enough medical specialists to meet the needs of the world. That's just too long. However, the technology exists today to dramatically speed up and make more accurate the medical specialists that we already have.
Now, what if there was a system where humans are not at the center and humans are not at the edge of the center? Well, what if there is a system where machines are at the center and humans are at the edge?
Many people don't know what AI or what the blockchain are. Many people even don't care. But they do care about how they can understand their health better and how they can improve it.
So what doc.ai does is it provides an incentive model to make it so people can provide both medical data, so things like what their blood results are, their height, weight, simple things like that, and then you know what types of diseases they have, what medication they're on, and then combines that with machine learning to draw conclusions. So maybe it could tell you that you should be on a different drug instead of the drug you're on, because maybe according to your genetics, that's actually a better medicine for you.
Neuron is the platform where we are going to decentralize the AI. Anyone can bring its own set of data.
Tokenization is just an extra bonus. It's an incentive mechanism for people who want to work on these hard problems that maybe they're not able to get paid through traditional methods to work on these hard problems, and for people who have rare diseases to maybe make some money off of their data for once. I just love the ability for this actual technology to get into the hands of people who really need it.
As a father, I'm really excited about the idea that for my family, I could know exactly what's happening with their health.
Today, you know, medicine is pretty broken. You know, like I have a chronic disease and the system is just entirely chaotic and broken. I think by actually doing smarter studies, getting more data, and using machine learning, we can actually start to fix that for the first time.
The way I look at it is whether or not doc.ai succeeds, doc.ai is going to be good for humanity.